start off with a statement. We'll get into it.
Yeah, obviously give credit to Penn State, number 7 ranked team in the country for a reason. Give them the ability to, obviously, I thought at halftime coming in, our guys would breathe a little bit. As bad as things went offensively in the first half, I thought we'd kind of responded in the proper way at the end of the second quarter, and I thought we'd come back out and do a continuation of what we did, but we just couldn't overcome. Anytime you have 5 turnovers, 4 picks, and one fumble, it doesn't matter how well you play on defense, you're not going to have success. So we got to do a really good job of cleaning that up. I do want our guys to know that there were some positives out there. There are good things that happened to some of our guys individually, but also collectively. We've made some stops. I think our defense, many times they were given the ball in bad situations to put their foot down and give up a field goal at best. It was a really good testament to them. I thought special teams, our guys again continued to battle. We blocked a field goal, put a hand on, I think, did they count that? They got a hand on the ball. Ryan Mead on a punt design that Dish had come back to me on Tuesday and we felt really strong about. So, just classic point there, right? Gets the side of his hand, the score of the game right there. If we get our hands on it, that's what literally changes games, right? So, dollar short in many different ways. I'd like this football team, 3 games into it. We're a 1-2 team going into our last non-conference opponent. So we got a week to get our boat right and play well against FAU. And obviously on the back end of that, have an 8-game conference schedule that we have to understand every one of those games is an opportunity to get better. So from an injury standpoint, it was difficult. I think Matt, had done so much to get back out there, and literally on the first play had a shoulder injury that he did enough to come back, had the strength back up, but then when he re-injured the second time, couldn't get it back to where it needs to be. So we'll do some, I know they'll do some tests on that later today. Don't really know the severity of that other than it just took him out of the game. I gave a lot of grit to our guys. I think Isaiah Adams got rolled up on that knee again, kind of twinged it, and Hunter came in and did a nice job, but then Isaiah came in and finished it, and I thought Isaiah to move over to right tackle and do that within a week's window, it just speaks testament to who he is, so excited for him. Got Caden Fagan involved, Aiden Loffrey involved, got some new guys touching the ball. It's good to see Malik make the play in the end zone there at the end of the game in a contested catch, so I think we're finding more players, which you need to do as a game as the season comes along. So disappointed, obviously our fans were out there today. I know we've made a lot about this and a great opportunity to show them and obviously didn't get a win for them, but I do know our guys compete and we're gonna put ourselves in a position to keep grinding and hopefully get a chance to win more games here in the short future. So with that, open up for questions.
Brett, the defense played really, really well today. What led to that after some struggles previously?
I think a couple things. First, after 2 games, we definitely had to take an inventory of where we're at, what we're doing. I didn't talk to it with our defensive players, but I showed our coaches, like, listen, we all had meetings and we had things we had to talk about. We had to stop giving up free yards, which I think was huge. And then the penalties, I don't know if defensively we had one in the game, but it was definitely a lot different for them in that regards. And then, my first year here, we gave up just under, it was like 498 to UTSA, and then we gave up 560 to Virginia. And I remember at that time having a conversation with the coordinator and everybody involved and said, hey, listen, we just can't play this way. We got to shut it off. And that's kind of what we had. I can understand, first down. I can understand the 3rd and 4 that they convert. What we can't give up is 36, 46, 38, 18, 19. Those plays just had to stop. So. There was still one before the end of the half today. I wish we could take that one back. That gave them a cheap 3 right before the half, which unfortunately gave them a little bit of mojo coming into the second half. But I thought our guys overall prepared well, which is why they played well.
Coach, what's your take on the 4 picks? Is there a common theme with those 4 throws?
Well, they threw them to the wrong guy, right? Just what it is. I understand 3rd down plays, right? But for us to be successful, who's ever in a quarterback, you can't have early down interceptions. We can't convert. We can't have that first drive, come and not put ourselves in a position to come away with points. We put so much into the start of the game. I basically give them 3 keys every week. The first was to identify, adjust, and excel on the things that we did from last week to get to where we were this week. And then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I just asked all the coaches to identify issues, adjust and excel the next day, and then we want to put it into game plan mode on Saturday. But the first football one was to start fast and play physical, and I thought for the most part offensively, defensively did that first drive. To have it end that way was frustrating, and have a missed field goal opportunity, it was just a lot of a lot of things that didn't, for you to beat the number one or the number seven team in the country, you got to have those things work, and they didn't.
Brett, is one of the positives what you're getting out of Reggie Love with the opportunities he's getting?
Yeah, I thought Reggie was, you know, Reggie's just been solid since I've been here. I've been excited to see him. He took over, you know, he started the game. I know him and Josh rolled through, but boy, he just got a nice little burst to him. He's patient, he understands, he's got a really good demeanor. I did like Josh's response. Obviously, I know he'd take back that play, just didn't protect it well enough. But I was excited to see Caden get in there, Aiden Loffrey to get in there and make a play. You know, you're going to have to, every year I've been in this league, you've liked, you know, I've always had a main guy and a second guy, but you'd like to have three guys that can kind of come in and play winning football, and hopefully we found out.
How fragile can it be for a quarterback, let's say Altmaier's age or any quarterback, but not just the four picks, the first drive undershot an open Brian right over the top. Just a really tough day.
And that's my fault, right? Like when we recruit quarterbacks, I tell them, you know, for me as a head coach, like it's always going to be on my shoulders. So we didn't have a good enough game plan for him to be successful. And I obviously want him to take these moments and grow. I don't think any reasonable change who's going to be our starting quarterback next week. I mean, I'll take a look at it, but I've seen this guy play some really good football, right? And do some good things in practice. He really doesn't waver. Tremendous faith kid that probably in that moment just wanted to make something more than he needed to do. And I've always just kind of believed, right? I understand third down interceptions. I understand you're going to get trick coverages and different things, but you can't have early down interceptions. We just can't. Never been a good football team that's won with early down interceptions. You know, interceptions are a part of the game. We're going to do with it, but we have to early down football. Is being efficiently with the football and the run game and the throw game to give you a chance to play another down, and that's what we got to do.
Just for clarity, it looked like Luke was limping a little bit.
Yeah.
The change, was that just the way the game unfolded?
No, he got hit low. You know, we're supposed to protect the quarterback, and I asked the officials about it. They said that they hit him in the stomach and fell down, so if that's what happened, that's great. There was a couple discussions that I had with the officials. Obviously, there was another time when they went airborne over a shield, which I know that is a 15-yard penalty, but that didn't see that way. There was an early grab on the sideline that I asked them to clarify, and they said that it was a bam-bam play, the first play over the middle. You know, so there was a number of things that got frustrating, and I'm sure we'll get good explanations. I'm excited because I think, you know, it's a Big Ten crew that will get better, and as a football team, we'll get better as well.
Him leaving the game wasn't injury-related, though, right?
No, I don't think it was feeling great, sure. but we didn't. No, it wasn't because of injury at the end. But I understand your question.
Coach, you know, Malik Elzey made some plays late in the game, and he was on the field quite a bit today. What do you want to get more out of?
Yeah, last week we kind of after the Kansas game, you know, we going into our second game, there was a group of freshmen that we wanted to play without a doubt, and you could kind of see who those guys were and what we were doing. So I just asked our guys to make a conscious effort about, let's, even if it's a handful of plays, like don't make them memorize the whole playbook if they're struggling with it. Like let's get these plays that these guys can be involved with and get them on the field, right? So from a standpoint of game plan wise, we were definitely trying to get Malik more involved. Caden Fagan, Aiden Loffrey, Griffin Moore, Luke, you know, obviously was our starting quarterback during the course of the week. So he got all the prep on those plays. And you know, another guy that Tip Ryman just continues to be an impressive guy that we have to get him involved in the game plan. So. We definitely want to get Malik in there and see him grow. He, like all young guys, he had kind of a rough week overall, but responded well with a Wednesday, Thursday practice. Had a little bit of a setback, but he overcame it, and I'm excited because I think this could be something that could propel him into the future.
Brett, I know Johnny's kind of known, but when you're getting that kind of play out of Johnny the last 2 weeks, what's that mean for you guys?
I could feel it during the course of the week. I could see it really going back to after the Toledo game. I know he – you guys that know him well just know his demeanor, and he played extremely well last week in the Kansas game. I know he was giving everything he can, and you know he was a big part of why I think our guys played better this week. He led that thing, and Keith, to be truth, you know, he got a pretty good shot last week in the Kansas game, had a huge bruise contusion on his shin that really limited him all week, and didn't know if we were going to have him out there, and he battled back and really Thursday turned the corner and gave us an opportunity to play him today. But we give him a lot of credit for being out there. I know Tariq also took a shot to the knee. It was a little banged up, bruised up, and it was frustrating for him. I don't think he was full go, 100% rodeo. So, but I do think our guys responded and played well. And I give credit to our defense coaches. They had enough perseverance when things kept getting set against them. They went out there and kept, having some pretty good success.
Coach, would you think a little more after this? How would you think of John Paddock today? I know he's short.
John Paddock?
Yeah. How'd you feel?
Yeah, tough spot, right? But we were within a 2-score game there for it was right there. And I'm like, that last pick kind of okay, we can't do this no more. We can't put him back out there and put John in. And of course, they're going to heat it up a little bit. So, that first series was a little bit rough, but he settled down, came back and, had that second series. And obviously the touchdown throw to Malik and, a guy that I've been very impressed. John's got great bloodlines. He has a grandfather and uncle here and his parents are great people. And he's been waiting for this opportunity. We'll sit down and talk about it as coaches to see where it goes. But it was good to see him the first time in action and have a little bit of success.
Big picture, Brett.
Finish with this one.
You talked a lot about the first 8 games last year and how after that just sort of lost contact with certain elements of what was going right. There's been 8 games since. Not that there's any magic to, 8 game increments. But do you feel like, have you lost a little footing? Is it going to be hard to get it back?
These guys are pretty resilient. I think as coaches, we realize, literally when we sat down and looked at the schedule, I'm always kind of a guy that looks big picture but small picture, and I knew these first 3 games were all going to be unique preps for us, FAU included. But these 3, I knew Toledo was going to have probably one of the best teams they've had since they've been there. I knew that Kansas was going to be a very difficult preparation coming out of a short week, and I knew they had a lot of skill sets. They ran some unique offensive schemes that were very difficult to get ready for, especially in a short week, and then obviously, I knew Penn State was going to be what they are. So I knew these first 3 games. I'd love to be 3-0. But I knew we'd have to battle our tail off to get to whatever record we can. So I'm not happy to be 1-2, but we've learned a lot of really good lessons, and we've learned some things I think that can help us in the 9 games ahead, right? And that's going to be the important part. I get the question, but I really don't. There's correlations you can tie into every year if you really look, but 2022 is behind us, 2023 is in front of us.
Thanks, guys.